is a party going on outside. Let me know how tolerable the stream is, because it is very loud. In a good way. In a good way. Hey, Buck81, you are the first one, buddy. Dirty Joe, 2 months, Lime Mile, 9 months, and tier 3. Thank you, Lime. How does it sound, guys? Let me know. I can adjust my music. I can't adjust the noise outside, but I can try to change the music or mic or anything. But, you know, there's a party outside, so it's fine with me. You're not gonna hear me complain about that. Let's try this. Thank you very much. They're doing some like an NFT drop or something. It's definitely a party. It's the most lively I think I've ever seen this place, this particular place. Theo Gantos, thanks for the 20 months, tier 3. Let's tuck that guy in. I'm playing very slowly right now. I'm gonna try to pick it up though. You guys can send me a challenge as well, !challenge. Get a few warm-up games in. I'll be able to stream for about 2.5-3 hours. Something like that. No, I'm leaving tomorrow, actually. Leaving tomorrow. My reading is down, man. The last session I had was brutal. I have a very nice drink as well, though. Remember, even if we're in another country. Thirsty Thursdays will continue to function. Good castle. 95 to c4 looks like a great maneuver for him. Need to get my speed up here. Go Bucks! Hey, what's up, Gray? We're watching the game, man. We got the game on in the background. We're almost gonna get them to turn on the game literally here, but we got the game on for ourselves. Ugh, this is a terrible move. This move just wins. So, I would normally go here, but then I'm gonna be blundering my bishop now. So I literally have to make a move that I do not want to make here. Yeah, this is not gonna be pretty. So, unfortunate. We'll survive, but yeah, this is not what we want. Almost lost the whole piece though. I mean, he literally just missed it, so I'll take it. I'm alive here. Hello, Chicken Pants, Neil. I miss you guys. I'll be back a little bit more normally tomorrow. Back in Calgary, so. Oh, Smooth just like kind of loses a pawn. Like a good move. . 36 seconds, so really not gonna be reliable first game, but I mean, we'll do our best. Dude, New York City's good, Chicken Pants. It's very good. Doesn't mean I don't miss, you know, you leave home then you miss home. That's how it works. But it's very good. I'm having a very good time. Okay. Let's see if I can do something in this game here. Unfortunately not. Right when I said, can we do something, we just blundered. Yeah, we're not gonna get this pawn back. Trying to go here desperately, but... want Rook F1. Not gonna get it though. We have 3 seconds. And... first game is always rough. Just getting things set up. Oops. I've actually mouse slipped both games. If you guys remember this game, mouse setup could be better. I could be better. But, yeah. Alright, we're playing the French. If you remember the first game, what did I do? I played D3. Right? This. Yeah, I played D3. And then game number two, I played E6 instead of E5. So, I've definitely been a little shaky on the mouse here. Hey, John Curtis. Oh, hey, thanks, man, for the raid. Just saw that. It's very nice of you. There are definitely a lot of people around. Yes, it is very bumping outside. I gotta have some of this very nice drink. Castled. I actually don't know what it is, Bizarre, but I know that it's very expensive. Do we go for this? This is playable. No, I didn't move to NYC. Just visiting. He's probably going to put a knight here. That's okay. Knight's never that great on G6. As you can see, it's kind of hampered a bit, but... I'm gonna take control of dark squares, so covering these squares with b6 and a5. You know, he's gonna put the knight here, he's gonna go f4. I get it. My position is not that great. Knight on g6 needs so much improvement. Yeah, well, unfortunately, I had something happen to me, Rebecca, during my time here, so I just sort of went on tilt and shaved my beard off, but I chipped my tooth. And there's a few things in the world that'll just tilt me off the planet, and dental stuff like that is just, it's so infuriating. And I have no idea how it happened. So my tooth was chipped, and I was just on tilt, and I just shaved my beard off. It was just one of those things where I was in a bad mood. And the last thing you want when you're in a bad mood is like an itchy beard or something. I was just like, fuck this, man. Fucking beard annoying my ass. So, that's why it's not there anymore. Knight e4 incoming? Certainly looks like it. Actually, f4 is incoming, what am I saying? Yeah, f4 is going to be the concerning move here. Might be in trouble. Well, I didn't go to the dentist to file. I'm gonna sort it out back in Canada. Gonna sort it out later. Trying to go trade queens here. Oh my god. Dude, I'm blind right now. I'm barely even focused. This is free. It's so free. What am I up to? Okay. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. I can't even count right now. Man. This move does not work, but I've already, you know, sort of tilted myself into playing it, so. So many moves that concern me here. So many moves. I don't think I can go there. I have to take that. 95, I have to take it. Which is not ideal. I was stopping 86, but clearly, clearly our chess needs a lot of work right now. I've been mouse slipping the first two games, and okay, played an interesting opening. We'll take the space. I've been mouse slipping and playing pretty slow, so there is absolutely a party in the background, which, you know, yeah, you're not gonna find. Find us complaining about that. Certainly gonna be some of the last people to be complaining. Dr. J Bird, thanks for the 8 months. A year from level 69 Warrior, Tutsi with the 5 months. Ranji for 30 months. Ranji, what do you mean? We got the Discord, man. We're happy to give more details. We're definitely interested in securing your presence, sir. We've been hanging out with a guy in New York City who looks a lot like you. He's been reminding us of you. Go, Ranji. Thank you, John, again for the 100 bits. Welcome. Lafong, hey, man. Thanks for the raid. That's a lot of people. As you can hear in the background, probably, there is, you know, there is some form of hosting going on. So certainly we don't mind a few more people. Thank you, Lafong. What's up, Tom? But New York City has been, it's been a real experience. It has. My body is just like not functioning. Certainly my brain isn't functioning for chess right now, but my body is barely functional as well. Before, I feel like I just like can't process chess moves right now. I don't know what to say. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, Ranji, trust me. It's nothing but a compliment. Again, this pawn is just like hanging, literally just hanging. I am out of it, for sure. Definitely out of it. maybe there was some other move to play there. Knight d5 is obviously on my mind. Knight b5 is great though. They have a DJ here, by the way. I'm sure you can really hear it right now. Like, you guys can really hear what's going on, right? Because they got a real DJ going at the moment. Here, I don't know. Crack the door open? I mean, it would be way too loud. Just would. I can't save this as well. See a good way to do this. Like this? It's got A3 coming next. Like, I don't even know what's going on. A3 is so strong. I'm playing chess. Like, this isn't even recognizable. My chess. Dude, like, I'm a shell of a human being right now. You can clearly see that the week has just taken its toll. I can't play chess at all right now. I'm a fraction of myself. A literal fraction. I don't even know what openings I'm playing. What are these? This looks like a frightening position. Why am I here? Don't look good at all. Yeah, this looks a bit scary, actually. That's quite good. I think I have to do this, and then knight f6, and then castle. Thanks, Josh. 75 months, NYC JGP, one of our longest viewers. I mean, all I can say is that 75 months, he's definitely seen me in this state before. And if his sub has continued to run that long, there has to be something redeeming about me. It's gotta be something. Okay, yeah, he did go here. I think we gotta just, but like we go here, takes queen h5, I mean, I don't know. There's definitely something up with my position. Yeah, it doesn't look good. I mean, we gotta do this. But I mean, queen f3 is just winning. Like, I am incapable. I mean, you know what we gotta do, right? We obviously gotta go king e6, but this is never what should happen in a position. Generally, if it does, you know, there's something wrong with it. So it's not like I necessarily see what's wrong with it, but there's gotta be something wrong with it. You thought these spells were soundproof? Well, Lopes, you have no idea. Like, what's going on outside? It's a full event. Which is fine. I'd much rather see a place lively and, you know, people having a good time. Like, that's cool. I'm okay with that. Believe me, this is the last stream to complain about that. Rav Shaki, thanks for the 6 months. Poured up Hambo. Cheers for the 10. It does look like the fried liver, I know. And that's a bad sign for me. Because it's... You don't want to play things that look like the fried liver. Trust me. Okay, I mean... This looks like a draw we might have to take. King d6 is the way to play on. And literally take with the bishop and bring the king in the middle of nowhere. I mean, I'm down on my luck, guys. I'm down on my luck. I think we literally need to do it. Oh, I realized that I don't even have to take. I'm actually hitting this queen. There are many, many things that I could be doing a lot better. I didn't even notice this queen would be hanging. After this, I was literally pre-moving that. That's not a good sign. What can we do here? Queen H8? I don't know. I'm just trying to trade queens. I'm just trying to trade queens, man. Maybe Queen H4 next? Try to continue trading. I actually really am, Rebecca. This is a very apt description. I am hiding with a chipped tooth. No one wants to look at me. Okay. I feel like we're supposed to trade. Or are supposed to be trying to trade. I can give up this knight eventually for the bishop. Hello, mannered monkey. Go mannered. Here he wants bishop d5. That's a heavy move. Interesting. That is a heavy move. What happens here? Obviously, I have no idea. Oh my god. What the hell is that? I think I just literally needed to win a game of chess, just to like remind myself what direction I chose with my life. Why I was somehow able to do this as a career. Jesus. At this point, I don't care how I get it. The win was just needed. Nicholas, thanks for the 7 months. Chalkfish, 9 months. Tomheim, 8 months. JHK23. Cheers, everybody. Hello, Naprosto. No, Canadian rock fan. Not quite. Not quite. So we got a very similar position to last time. I'm going to try to play it a bit faster. We're gonna go a5, knight a6. Knight there here, and knight there we'll go c2. Okay, now these bring another knight here, I might reconsider. Might have to reconsider. Not that much. But I think I need to move it because knight e5 is kind of a threat. Not quite the pros though. Although, easy to arrive at that conclusion. Thank you. I'll tell you guys more about the whole trip another time. Mostly because it's not over yet, so I mean, yeah, I'm leaving tomorrow, but that means there's still tonight to survive. So yeah, best not to tell the stories until they've all happened. That's a surprising move, but I've been playing some surprising chess. Knight A2 is not a good move, but I'm lazy. I'm very lazy at the moment. All I want to do is trade pieces. I can't calculate. Less pieces on the board, the better. Nose knows all, thanks for 34 months. Dad or something. I'm gonna play B3 badly. Not because it's a great move, just, you know, it solidifies things. It covers things. Really want to take that. Like, allowing F4 just looks like a nightmare, so I'm gonna take it. But I'm really not happy with that decision. I just don't want to allow the pawn. Let's trade that bishop off again. I mean, we're not playing well, it's clear. So, when you're not playing well, you gotta start thinking about all possible ways to win. Just flagging, ruthless flagging is needed here. Is the Astro still associated with chessbrah? Definitely. I think Eric's going to try to get him to stream. That's a great move, by the way. Going to try to get him to stream from St. Louis. I need to sack my rook for this bishop. If I get to do that, I might be a happy boy. But until then... It's amazing. I didn't even see that. I did not even see that move. I'm seeing none of these moves. Like, they're just not even occurring. Not even close. I got a sack for this bishop here. I'm just waiting for a good time to do it. Like, it has to be then. We are getting our wins in crazy ways! Like, what? What are these? What are these wins? So undeserved. So undeserved. What's the noise in the background? That is a party. Or an event being held at the place that we're streaming from. Hello, Bozo. You guys can actually hear, like, it's kind of weird, but you guys can actually hear the music or what's going on other than my stream better than I can. Seriously. You guys are saying Amy Winehouse? I can barely hear the music. These headphones are like, I'm also like nearly lost here or something. yeah, we're like in trouble. Does this work? I feel like there's no way it works. We're gonna play it anyway. Do I recommend these headphones? Well, depends what your goal is. Oh, yeah. I can't even take it. That makes a lot of sense. Dummy. But dude, I'm like, I mean, there's no chance for me right now. There's no chance. Not in my current state. Yeah, if you want headphones that cancel, I would say for sure. These are clearly HyperX. Personally, I know it's better to listen to music, but as a streamer and how many people we like have on stream as a guest, I don't like noise-canceling headphones, which is a very unpopular opinion because I like to be able to hear what's going on in the room and like who's approaching and like who's nearby. I am actually not a fan of headphones like this, but I know that's not a popular opinion. Oh, that was a very clever move. It's almost like he knew I was going to pre-move. Well, I got to resign that and the piece is just trapped. Definitely bored. I mean, the amount of liquor consumed is just like otherworldly. I don't even know how I'm functioning. Thanks, Ubitsia, 69 months. Doriano, 24. Is that 2 years on the dot? It is 24. Yes, it is. Monkey Elf, thanks for 9 months. Bozo, 39 months. Ukraine NM's on crack? I think you're misunderstanding, buddy. I'm the one that's on crack here. I am the one that's on crack. He's playing this like it's a thing, like it exists. You know? Buck81, thanks for gifting a sub as well. I mean, I might have to just like play an opposite bishop position here and offer a draw. You know, just sort of claim some points. Yeah, Tulum is a bright spot. Like, yeah, something to look forward to. Something to look forward to for sure. C5 is maybe a move, but doesn't look that good. I can take a C7. At least it'll be imbalanced. Yeah. There's a lot of things to take here. I think we do want to take that. My opponent has offered me a draw. I should probably take it, but this is arguably the best position, you know, we've had all night type of thing. So I need to play it on. It just doesn't get better than this for me. This is a privilege. A privilege to have this. If it's a draw, it's a draw, but we'll at least find that out. Makes to put this back here. King up, try to push these pawns. Yeah, I could easily see myself losing this. Easily. Jimbly, thanks for the half year. Jason Pierce, Sweeney. 45 months is a long goddamn time. Thank you, Jason. Hey, Joe Cool, 7 months. What is up? I think he needs to go aggressive. Yeah, go up the board, so to speak. He's not doing that, which is, I think, nice for me. We'll try this. I mean, I literally could just be losing this game, but I have to try to win it. If I'm playing it on, I gotta try to win it. I got two connected pass pawns, and this bishop covers that pawn, so I'm trying to say that, you know, we play here and we kind of run these guys up the board type of thing. It's important in opposite bishop end games to run your pawns on the opposite color of your bishop, so meaning my pawns are going to be on light squares together, and then I'm going to push and then go on light squares together. You never want to have your pawns like two dark squares at the same time. That's almost always a bad idea. And this is just a whatever move, and now I'll make sure to put them on two light squares again. This pawn is pretty much irrelevant. Okay, now that the bishop has to cover this square, my king is free to literally walk in and take all the pawns. Because the bishop's tied down here and my bishop's covering that. In a long game, this is an easy draw? Yes, Iron Galaxy. In a long game, that is a very easy draw, I would say. Not even a draw that you'd have to think twice about. As an experienced player, I would say. But in a slow game, in a faster game, I think that can be won more times than it deserves to be. Like this, for example. This is a good example.
I'm bleeding money there. Can you lose a couple of times? Just throw a few games.
Buddy.
Just taking all my money.
Really? Oh my god.
I'm just kidding. Well, I'm not kidding. I thought the plethora of Japanese food and a little bit of alcohol, I had an edge. I have no edge. I'm down $40.
Fucking hell, man.
Don't throw any games. Try to win.
Believe me, I'm trying. And it's not working. That's how bad it is. Like, my chess looks so bad right now that it looks like I'm not trying to win my games. No, I'm not at home right now. I'm not at home right now. I'm in a kind of, like, chic-ish kind of spot where you have no idea, like, who could just, like, walk in. Because they're doing some weird, like, NFT drop, even though it's, like, a gamer bar. So, yeah, it's an interesting spot. Who is that? That is a very cool guy that we've been hanging out with and has been showing us the best that New York City has to offer. Definitely indebted to him for the good time I'm having. Hey, good night, Buck81. Sorry, I've been poorly attentive to the resubs and support thus far, mostly because, as you can see, I require 99% of my brain to play an average chess game right now. And usually, I don't require that much of it, and I can allocate the rest to being a decent streamer. But what's this? This looks like a move I would play. It's like a hambo move. So here, queen there. He like takes all my pawns. Yeah, I get that. I get that. I'll step out of the way. I can respect that, I guess. Maybe I just go here. Fine. I don't know what the name of the NFT. I don't know anything about it. I don't really give a shit about NFTs. That's just me. Not only do I not care about it, but it just like doesn't make sense to me. So, those are all the comments I have on NFTs. Azorius, thanks for the 7 months. From Brazil, hello, hello. I got to play so much faster. We'll go here after queen g4. I mean, he wants to set up some stuff. Defile, thanks for the gifted sub. I guess this works. I don't know, man. I don't know anymore. I assume all this stuff just works. I gotta go bishop g7. Unfortunately, that's a good move. So there's no more queen g4 check, which is nice. Knight h5 check, though. I mean, I don't have any way to avoid a draw that I can see. And I think he knows that, so he might just take this draw here. It's nothing I can do. I mean, draws are just so annoying, so lame, but I have no way to avoid it. I mean, yeah, if he wants a draw there, he can get a draw. Can't do much there. Logan, thanks for the 2 months. Queen g7 mate. Well, I assume you mean h7, and no is the answer. I mean, our chess needs some help right now. That much is clear.
Anybody? Can I do a cheers with you?
Yes.
At some point.
But is that yours?
I have extra if you'd like. This is on the rocks.
Yeah, I don't, I'm done.
Oh, perfect. Would this be good? Whiskey on the rocks?
Is it the same?
No, you got the best stuff in the building. I'm not drinking. I'm below. You got the best stuff in the building.
It tasted like the best stuff in the building.
You want to smell it? Tommy's here. Your friend Tommy's here.
Really?
Yes. I got him here.
That's hilarious.
And you never met him because you weren't in town, right?
No.
So,
Tommy.
At some point, I wanted to adjust the subs today. I was making looks. Did we get it? We got some subs?
Or no?
Oh, the donation and the. I get it. We didn't get any subs.
No, exactly.
But I'm betting on you in your games, and I'm starting to catch up in the betting.
Well, you must have got in at a good price.
Yes, I did.
I mean,
because you started 3-0, letting me bet the spread.
It's been brutal.
I fell for the same opening trap as you did against the same guy last week on stream.
The double knights attacking c7.
Yeah.
I fell for the same thing. Same brutal. Thing. Same thing.
I'm a noob, man. This is like, you should be basic.
Look.
This guy's insane. Tommy Shelby is a fucking troll. Go Tommy fucking Shelby. Tommy in New York City is fucking funny. Okay, one sec. I'm losing a lot of fucking games right now, and I'm down a lot of time, so just seeing some. Hello, Johnny! Dude, I played that move so fast, he almost fucking believed me. You see that? It took him so long to take that. I'm tilted from this game. Kappa, not really tilted. I'm playing so bad. That was like one of my better games. So what it means is that I need to just start a new game. I'm down like a minute or whatever it was, you know. It was such a bad attempt at, you know, playing for a win. I've got this guy drawing on demand, he's just crushing me, 5.5, 3.5. So we're gonna bring it back, but it's not gonna be the easiest operation that I've ever undertaken. No, Kamalu, I mean, listen, I give this guy his credit, man. He's an NM, he's playing fine. Like, he's out here. But I am playing like an asshole right now. I'm obviously not gonna be happy with myself first. So let's see if we can at least get a few games back. By the way, it's fucking hot! Holy smokes, it's hot! I am burning up in here. I'm burning up. Bishop d7. Let's go. If I play just a little bit, little tiny bit decent, just a smidge, I can put up a performance. But I am not playing well. A4 he wants. He wants to just play A4, A5. I get that. Let's fucking put that guy there. Let's stop A4. A4 looks annoying to me. A4, A5 might get some energy. Mlushy, thanks for the prime sub. Bring the rook over. I mean, at some point I may even like have to take this and go F6, E5, which is okay. That's not the end of the world. But like knight g4, I think I should almost go back. Even though I might actually get mated here in a bad way. Okay, let's take that. Double here. I'm up on time, and you guys have seen my chess today. Like, the only way I'm winning a game is on time. Like, let's get real. This guy's a fucking troll. He's coming at me with his dad bod. Tommy. Okay, I'm bringing the bishop back, which is a decision. It really is. I'm just gonna toss this guy here. Move the king back after queen f4. f6 and e5 is something that doesn't look crazy. Now I'm down on time, so definitely not a good look what's happening. I feel like the knight on g4 is not well placed. Knight h4 and knight f5 can be annoying if I just go back here, I feel. So let's wipe that. Oh, I just realized the time. Okay. Trouble. There's no way. Yeah, I was gonna say. I wasted time going back and forth, unfortunately. So I was gonna say, there's no way that we actually can win that, because I didn't realize that he had less time than me. Otherwise, I would have flagged his ass easily. Oh, I would have committed to that from miles away. But I wasted time going back and forth with the kings when I didn't need to. Could have just immediately started pre-moving, basically. So once I did that a few times, I realized, yeah, okay, if I'm not able to use those squares, I'm probably not gonna be doing anything too impressive this game. Let's take here. Draw, rip. Yeah, I'm never a fan of draws, but, I mean, what can you do? Can't win every game. It's better than losing, but it always feels worse than losing somehow. Draws are just so unsatisfying. It's kind of like if you're like making a bet, sometimes, I feel like you have to just like be a degenerate to understand this perspective, but sometimes it literally feels better to lose money than to have your bet void. It's like once you've made the decision to commit money to a bet, you just want to see you make money or you lose money. Let's go here. Do I like my position? No, obviously. My position's shit. So bad. I can't play chess. Like, I just can't at all. So hot in this, I need to take my clothes off. You'd rather get blocked on Tinder than be friends. There we go. Exactly. Yeah, this is fucking shit. This is a very uncomfortable position. Sweating fucking buckets right now.
Come on, I have an issue. He's walking around with an empty drink for 20 minutes. Empty. Isn't it strange? Like empty, fully empty, but he's holding it.
It's terrible. It's bad etiquette.
I'm on to this very bad etiquette. Fully empty.
Terrible etiquette. He's got to rectify that. You can't be walking around with an empty drink. Can anyone vouch? Can anyone contribute their opinion here? If there's a party going on and you have a drink that's empty and you're walking around holding it for a long period of time, it's just bad etiquette. Put the glass down. I'm just getting fondled here, like, unequivocally fondled. I have no prospects. Also, I'm not rescuable. How's the football game? Does anyone know the football score? What's up, champ? We're lost here. Put it that way. We are in trouble. Pretty soon I'm gonna start stripping. It's way too hot. There's no chance we make a comeback, right? I have 26 seconds and I can't calculate anything. Like, the brain's dead. Comeback is so off the cards that it's making me think it's possible. Ugh. Disgusting. Disgusting. Unfortunately, it's not possible. What do you know? I need to strip. It's literally, there's sweat on the fucking, the headset, just dripping. I'm just fucking dripping. Yes. Yes.
Bucks are up 28-7, my guy.
28-7.
So you're, yep. Get some puck in your...
Do we need... So at this point, we need the Eagles.
Support, yes, yes, I
right?
I do. Oh. Sorry, it keeps falling off.
No, it's not your fault. Oh. This thing is busted. We need a handyman. Let me take empties for you, dude.
Yep, that's
just
it.
Just this one?
Just this one.
Okay.
Oh, actually...
Yeah, chug that. All right, Ben.
The Bucks are up 28-7. I'm going to chug.
So grab it by the lock
okay.
while you push it.
Okay, sounds good. Sounds good, bud. Oh,
okay.
I'm not good at like differentiating
no,
between
it's,
holes.
It's,
like
yeah.
like I don't know the difference between one hole and another. But can I get you anything?
Understandable. I don't think you can. Like I don't think there is a altered carbon sleeve you could put me in that would make me play better. I don't think there's a sleeve.
Tommy loves the music.
He's
vibing.
It's crazy.
But Big Nicola just resubbed. That's a name.
I'm such a bad streamer right now. I'm like.
But I'm betting on you.
Not able to like.
Go
multitask.
Nicola. Go
like,
Korn.
It's crazy.
Thank you for the resubs, Nicola Stoltzen and Korn.
Thank you, Laker. Korn.
If you're feeling
Nicola.
Like Jager bombs or anything, just let me know.
Is our young friend here?
The youngest has not arrived yet.
Okay. They definitely have not, Nicola. It is still in trouble. Nicola is another guy that I had the pleasure of running into in New York City, and very happy that that was possible. I don't know what's going on in this position. I mean, I have to play this, surely. I think I want to play here. I don't really know what's happening in this position at all. At all. But it's lively. It's lively. Knight takes d6 looks like a stellar move. Yeah, I'm obviously losing this pawn, but it was never really about keeping the pawn. Bishop e5 maybe? I think he's gonna sack for that pawn. Like rook c2, rook takes type of thing. It looks too easy to sacrifice for the pawn. That's what I don't like. Also, we're down the like trademark amount of time. 1 minute. It's just too much. Yeah, like bishop d5 looks like a fucking move. Like, there's so many moves. I'm gonna get mated here in the back rank. I can already feel it. Nope, I didn't even see it was my move. That's not a good start. I'm trying to give him some checks and deliver a mate, but it's just not gonna happen. Buis. Why did he just do that? Well, it's not like I'm doing anything at least. note today. It's, I mean, when it's not your day, you have to find ways to get your wins or get your points in other methods. It's just clearly not my day, so it's never gonna be me just beating this guy like over the board or something. Fight through it, exactly. That's what you gotta do. We all have bad sessions. I'd like to say that the chessbrah channel is a place where bad sessions are on full display. A very human channel. Trust me, I don't always play good chess. You've probably seen me playing some of my worst right now. I often complain about how poorly I play chess, but it's only backed up by the actual chess right now. Like, the chess that you're seeing from me, I think you guys can understand my complaints when I say I'm just playing like I'm a different person. I can't see basic things. I am losing tons of points to, you know, low-rated players. And we gotta battle through those. Let's see if we can come out on top. I don't even think I played London today, so let's see if the London is the answer. That's been what's missing. Just gotta play the London system. Low worship. Samba star, yeah, relatable streamer, that's me. That's me. You guys are all GMs as well, GM chat, so I feel like I'm a, you know, pretty relatable kind of guy. I'm getting rid of that knight so this fucker doesn't go here, here, and here. That plan is so annoying. So if you're ever playing these positions, that's the plan you go for as black. That's what you go for as black. Can you see the party? I can't even see the party. You think I'm gonna let you guys party and not me? Hell no. You have a rule where you don't play drunk or hungover? I had that rule as well until Wednesday. The night on E3. Is that Jack Daniels? No. All I can say is that this is a lot better than Jack Daniels. A lot better. Okay, we gotta take this. Gotta play the knight against the bishop here. Give it a go. Solo Timbo, thanks for the 15 months. Mike Morton, 28 at tier 3. Appreciate that a lot, Mike. I mean, I think we might have to take this. F3 is also tempting, I gotta say. Fuck it. Let's play F3. Takes takes, rook G5. Okay, glad he kind of didn't do that. F4 he can take. We gotta go king F2. We gotta get out of the pin. But, now that we're out of the pin, I can take that and go rook E8. That's interesting. You know what else is interesting in a weird way is playing this move? It doesn't work, but it's an idea to like trap the rook, right? The rook would be trapped on F5 with the pawn on F4, so I'm just thinking about stuff like that. It doesn't fully work, though. I think we gotta go here. F4 coming up. If I can get F4 and knight F5, I'm chilling, because then... here. I mean, rook e8, we trade that, and I think the endgame is winning. We just need to get outside h-pawn, or to get outside h-pawn, we need to play g4 and go like that. I think he wants to go, I don't know, b4? He must want to go B4. I don't understand what else he's trying to do, so... So we're gonna go here. Even though it looks like not a good move to break up your pawns, I need a pass pawn. So the fact that I'm able to get a pass pawn here should be very good. This move looks top tier by him, but... can I go here? No. Yeah, I guess we just go back. These are just elite moves, man. Can I take? Surely I can take. Surely we can take. Big Brian. All right, let's keep this pass on. Take, put the rook behind the pawn. Now we should be winning on the spot. Yeah. That's what we should do. Yeah, Iron Galaxy. It's not that b4 by him was like a great move. It's just that it gave his rook some open lines to actually enter my position. And it's better as a human player to be doing something than not. So if you're, as a computer, sometimes the best way to defend a position is to sit there and literally do nothing. The best move in the position is gonna be like shuffle your king, literally. But as a human player, shuffling, unless it's very clear that your opponent can produce nothing, is one of the worst feelings in the world. It feels like your opponent is accomplishing something while you're accomplishing nothing. And that is not a good feeling in chess. Almost all the time, if your opponent is doing something and you're not, then your position is not getting any better, and your opponent's position definitely is. What you have to understand, if you're ever going to let your opponent do that, is that your opponent's position will never get, ever, ever get to a position. It's never going to improve enough that it's winning. And that is hard to recognize. It's hard to like make that distinction. It's like, oh yeah, I can let my opponent improve his position because I'm aware that his position is never going to improve to the point where he can win it. And yeah, it's that's not easy to evaluate. So that's why fortresses are so, I don't know, the word is rare. Like, a lot of people don't believe in fortresses. Like Magnus. Magnus doesn't believe in fortresses. I'm gonna need a fortress right now to not fucking lose this game. Tell you that. Apple juice? No, trust me. This is far from apple juice. Far from apple juice, my guy. Brian McNee is like definitely a frightening opponent, I have to say. Like I don't feel good playing Brian. I am aware that he is a big chief. And he's able to come at. Like I'm in big trouble. I mean F5 is just a fucking murderous move. It is a murderous move. Exactly, reliable Randy. It's a lot better than Jack Daniels. Better as in quality-wise. And taste. But, yeah, a lot better than Jack Daniels, and certainly not apple juice. That's what you get to know. E-squaw. So I don't know if anyone has had, like, issues with their teeth the way that I have. I was telling you guys earlier I chipped my tooth, so I haven't been in the best mood, but when you have issues with your teeth, they seem to like consume you. At least they do for me, which is like very frustrating. It's just, it's something you think about, you feel, you notice, and it like consumes your entire being. Not in a good way. Let's put the rook here. Teeth problems are the worst because they're so small in proportion to your body, but they affect your entire body. It doesn't feel good. It's just like such a small issue, and it feels like it's blown out of proportion in a crazy way. Just gonna fucking pre-move that? What's going on here? Are you guys seeing what I'm seeing? Is he pre-moving? He's pre-moving literally all his moves. What? Brian? Hello? Brian? Like, whose man's is this? He's pre-moving fucking everything. I don't like playing Brian anymore. He was kind of chill for one game, but now Brian's like kind of coming at me. Not in a nice way. Not in a nice way at all. Hey, Brian, I'm not sure I like you, man. Brian's strong. I'm also playing like ridiculous. He's gonna get Rook D2. He's a gamer. Gonna play for a win though, which is necessarily good news for me. He took the draw. I would have beat myself in that position. 19 seconds to 10. I think White wins those. So take it. Juby Julia, thanks for the 8 months. It always feels better when you get a draw like that, and you're not the one that did it. You know, like, he's the one that made that decision to take the draw. So that's fine. If I'm the you know, bend over backwards simp who makes that draw, please, sir, can I have a draw? Then I feel bad. But when your opponent makes the draw, you can be like, oh yeah, fucking, I didn't want that draw. Not at all. This guy took it. He's the guy. Hello, Pranav. You gotta get this knight into e5. It is hot. It is really hot. I don't know. Like, in order for the sound to be presentable for you guys, I'm basically in like a streaming hot box right here. I don't know if that's like visible or if that's clear, but it is very sweaty in here. Drop the bishop to b1 of knight b4. Hello, Gopher. Looking forward to seeing you, buddy. Very soon in Calgary. Okay, I mean, the only thing that's gonna make me feel better is news about the Bucks winning. Is that news that exists? Are Tom Brady and the Bucks saying hello right now? Hello, Moose. Who's streaming right now? That's a great question. That is a great question. I am doing my best, but I can't say I'm putting my best performance out there. 28-14. I'm in the fourth, like just started, or in the fourth, like there's some time. Two touchdowns, I'll take it. I have the spread, which is -7. So that's only good for one more touchdown. So it's not at all like it's in the bag or anything like that. I'm dropping this piece, and I'm also fucking dropping the other piece. It's just not a good look. Man, Brian is tough. I don't like playing Brian. Fuck Brian. He's good, man. I'm gonna lose a piece here. H6 looks disturbing. But we've seen this from Brian before. He all of a sudden just like randomly starts sending moves. Absolutely sending. Could use another TD. Iron, that's exactly my feeling. Could use another TD is a great way to put it. E4 knight there, but it's gonna come down to the fact that I have no time. I need to do so much here, like it's crazy. The improvements that need to be made to my position. Decisions. Trust me, Rook F3 is monstrous. Rook F7, but I'm so low on time that I don't think it'll matter. Thanks for the 18 months. Dude, the fact that my reading is above... it's done, I guess. The fact that my reading is above 2700 right now is a fucking miracle. It is a miracle. I am not playing like a 2700 right now. I'm not even playing like a 2600 right now. What's up, the club party sounds? I'm at a place where the streaming booth is awesome. I got a setup here. It is killer. But they're hosting an event outside. I don't mind. Hope you guys don't mind. It's Thirsty Thursdays, man. Golden B, thanks for the 1 year. Zenbound 10 subs. That is, it's been a rough night for me. Hope you can understand. My chess has been unacceptable. For Zenbound to still come in with 10 subs is a level of appreciation that we should all aspire to have. Find you someone that supports your chess the way Zenbound supports my chess. A guy named Dick Inchin. I've clearly got enough dick today. There's no way. One second. Back in time to watch myself flag. Trust me, guys, if Tommy Shelby knocked on the door and said he was leaving, I think everyone in here would forfeit a chess game to speak to Tommy. He's been watching the channel for a long time, supporting it for as long. Tommy Shelby, what a guy, what a character. He actually visited Montreal when we used to stream in Montreal, and I just by literal chance happened to not be in Montreal when he visited. So I've never met the guy, just met him and his wife. Beautiful people. Yeah, Neil met Tommy. So I would just like to say that I think a lot of us here would lose a 3-minute blitz game to talk to Tommy Shelby. I think that's a fair statement. Unfortunately, I just lost dick, so I did take a hit here. I'm not happy about this, by the way. I am not happy about this, but I did just get dicked. However, I still maintain the notion that Tommy's worth it. I got dicked pretty bad here. Enchin as well. Okay, I thought this guy's name was Dick Champ. If his name was Dick Champ, it would have been over for me. There's too many dicks at once. His name's Din Champ, thank God. I don't know if I could handle another dick. One, you know, I think we might all better ourselves to handle, but back to back? Jesus. No way. Jarbs. 2017, 2018 we moved, went to Calgary, but yeah, Montreal, like the city, just, I realized at some point that Montreal is not a city that I ever want to live in. It's a city that I want to visit a lot, and I will be back to Montreal probably many times in my life. It's a great place, but it's not a place I want to live. I realized that a few years into my stay. No Montreal slander? Well, I'm only against slander at all. I think that's actually a very popular opinion. Montreal's a great place, but living there as a non, like, native French speaker, I mean, Quebec, Quebec is racist, it's just something racist. Like, they don't like Anglo, they don't like Anglos, straight up. So, it's not a nice place to live if you're not from there. That's just facts. So, I think that opinion is not too uncommon, basically. But I love Montreal. I have nothing but good things to say. It's just not a long-term place for me. Everyone's different. But I'm just saying for me. Hey, what's up, John? Any NFL updates, boys? I'm flagging this game, so it's just hard to focus. I'm having a good time here. I'll be back to normal streaming like tomorrow, the day after. Probably the day after. I'm traveling a bunch tomorrow, but I'm having a good time. I'm not a very good multitasker. The environment that I'm streaming in right now is so cruel. It's just like hard to focus, I guess is the best way to say it. A3 is really strong here. Should have played A3. I'm gonna put a knight on D5 now. I'm happy about that. Show the view. I don't think I can do that. Not that I don't want you guys to see. It's not an easy setup to like recreate if something goes wrong. So I don't want to fuck with it. Tampa crushing Philly in fourth. But it's still 28-14. Okay, so it's still one touchdown away from my bet not hitting, which I'm not sure if I like. Okay, I am fucked, by the way. This guy's a quick player. I'm in trouble. I know I'm in trouble. He's like playing faster than me with 2 minutes. Like, I'm fine about playing him, but it's not going to be good enough. Something fucking happen here, boys. Can I make something happen? I can barely even grab the pieces. Ugh! I think we just fucked it. Oof. That was a particularly bad move by me. We're just gonna have to resign the game. Like, we're not able. In fact, this makes more sense. I am below 2,700 now. Like, the way that I'm playing, there's no way that this should be maintained. It's a mess. How am I still over 2,700? Like, I'm not even a human right now. John OB18, Strawberry Rodeo. Thanks for the resubs. Back to 2,800 stream? That'll happen in Calgary. It'll happen in Calgary. I'm just streaming to hang out. I miss you guys. I'll stream tomorrow. Sorry, the day after tomorrow. I gotta travel all day tomorrow. So, I'll be back in the usual setup in a few days. My fucking tooth is still chipped, like, in half. So I'm, like, a massive tilt from that. 28, 21 bucks on top. That is very, very bad to hear. Wait, how did the bucks get to 28 from 24? By the way? Or were they at 24? What was the previous score? Oh, wait a minute. Fuck. It was 28 to 14. No, this is exactly what I was saying. Dude, the spread is minus 7. 28-21 is not... Oof, that is not good. Okay, the spread's not hitting right now. Yikes. That's bad. Minus 7. Most books had it minus 7. Or at least... My bets are minus 7. Who's going for 2, Gory? What do you mean going for 2? If they had 14 and they're at 21, they've already got... They already added the extra point, no? Oh my god, he took this way. I didn't even see that till now. That's a crazy decision. Oh my god, they got the conversion. I'm fucked, boys. The worst thing could happen. It could just be that it's 28-22. And we just take L's. Ordrin, I asked the same question. Why do you go for 2? To me, it makes no sense. No sense. But there is some math, there are some analytics that say that you should go for 2-point conversion. Now, what I can say from watching the NFL this year is that fucking extra points are missed, like, left, right, and center. It doesn't make sense. These extra points, they're, like, irrelevant. It's like a 50-50 chance whether you make it. I mean, not that bad, obviously, but it seems unacceptable how many kickers miss extra points. Way unacceptable. Extra points, like, I swear to God, like, extra points used to be automatic in football. I don't know if that's literally the case, but this is a terrible move, by the way. Ooh, that was a mouse slip for that, because now he's going to fucking put his knight there. I don't know. Anyway, that was not the move I wanted to do. This mouse is, you know, I don't have full control over this mouse, put it that way. I have 37 seconds, also. We're not winning games. I'm just hanging out, taking L's. Party Poker, Latin America, thanks for the raid. 143 people. It's a lot of people. Yeah, they moved it back, but still, it feels like, you know, if your literal job is to be paid to kick a fucking ball, you should be able to do it from what is it, 25 yards? It's like, come on, boys. Come on, boys. I mean, when you're down this much time, you just kind of have to take what you can get. This is probably just draw. There's nothing to do here. Nothing to do here. That's a good call, Emmett. The thing is, Emmett, the only argument I have, other than fully agreeing with you, is that, you know, my job is to play chess. My job is not to play chess well. A kicker's job is to kick it through the uprights every opportunity they get. Every opportunity. I'm an entertainer. I'm trying to put on a show as well. But I just feel like a, whatever it is, 33-yard field goal should be something that gets hit more often than it does. Maybe that's unfair to say, but when you think about how consistently people can do things that they work their, they train their entire lives to do, like people can do the Rubik's Cube in like, you know, fucking literally 4 seconds or something ridiculous, kickers should be able to nail a 33-yard field goal, like, more often than they do. ...90% completion isn't that bad. I mean, yeah, I guess it's not. I always relate it to, like, you know, I guess when you think about free throws, those are another thing that I always have qualms about, and I think the percentage is probably a lot lower than that. Obviously, it's a lot lower when you think about all the players that shoot free throws, because some people are not good at free throws. But I still have qualms with free throws. Like Mike McDonald, our buddy. Buddy Timex McDonald. I mean, he just made a bet that he could nail, what was it, 90 out of 100 free throws? And he fucking did it. With like, I don't know, a year to train. And I get it, it's not in a game scenario. There's a lot of reasons why it's easier than what the athletes have to deal with, but still. It's pretty impressive. Yeah, exactly. Tommy Shelby's the key to it all. Free throw is repetitive, yeah. And there's other factors in the pat, right? You obviously got, you know, the hold, the spot, the distance, the wind. Many, many factors. Getting it blocked? Sure, yeah. But at least getting it blocked literally does happen extremely rarely, but you're right, of course, there's more factors than what I just listed. Places out. Well, I feel like laces out is kind of more what I was saying about the holder. Kind of like factors into that. Never seen a free throw get blocked, but in fairness to the guy shooting free throws, there's literally an entire stadium of people that are trying to get you to miss the free throw with these like fucking whatever they're called. Just like slapping together. You know. It's not the best environment to shoot a free throw either. Same with the kick. I don't think it matters as much. This is my armchair opinion, but I don't think it matters as much with the kicks. Like, they're a lot further away. When you're sitting at the, like, pat line, after a touchdown, kicking a field goal, you're so much further away from fans than when you're at the free throw line, shooting a free throw. Or do we? Let's go here, see what happens. I'm actually gonna be commentating with, speaking of Giannatos, Peter, good friend of mine, taught at the Charlotte Chess Center. He's got a great, great thing going on there. I'll actually be commentating with him. They're hosting a tournament later in October. I think it's called the Blitzcoin Invitational, or maybe Blitzcoin something. It's they're playing for a piece of one Ethereum, I think, or one Bitcoin, not sure. Maybe one Bitcoin. And yeah, I'll probably be doing some commentary with him later this month. Well, Chicken Pants, I know, like, I don't claim to be correct about what I'm saying. I'm just an angry guy betting on football and, you know, having an extra point fuck my bet, so I'm just complaining. But I am serious when I say that, like, this isn't from a place of, like, you know, I was just exposed to watching a lot of football and seeing these fuckers miss extra points like madness. I don't know what the stats are, but these bastards missed so many extra points that it was just tilting. Like, and that's why I'm on this rant right now about extra points. Like, I just don't think they should be fucking missing that much. That's an interesting question, Polar Bear. Do I think that I could hit, you know, a good percentage of pats after a year of training? That's a very interesting question. I think that, like, Timex could. I think that Mike McDonald could. It's just so rhythmic that I absolutely think he could. But me, I don't know if I'm built for that type of bet. You know? Okay, I have to just, like, remotely focus for a second. I'm not cut out for these time scrambles, unfortunately. I have, like, you know, I gotta get it set up here, but it's not the home setup. You guys know how it is. When you're not in your home setup, you're just not sharp with the speed the way you usually are. 5 lives, thanks to 10 months. K Mysterio. I love that name. 20 months. It's the reset. I'm fucking getting obliterated right now. Obliterated. How many attempts do I get, Chicken Pants? You're telling me that I kick one extra point and it has to go in? Kicking an extra point on stream. And obviously I can train for that. I mean, I don't think I would train for it. I would practice a little bit, but... I think in my lifetime, Chicken Pants, I could... You know what, Chicken Pants? I think I could do that. And I think I could do it wearing a CeeDee Lamb jersey. Go Cowboys. 28-22, the game's over. Are you guys serious? You see, I'm getting fucked here, right? Because they're able to kick a field goal. They're able to kick a field goal. They're right fucking there. But of course they're not, because they win the game if they kneel. I'm getting fucked sideways by this. Yeah, oh man, that's an L. That's a big L. They're literally at the fucking goal line. Oh, that's rough. That's rough. Yeah, fuck me, man. I don't deserve to win a bet when I'm playing chess like this, I guess. You have to think of the big picture. Gotta think of the big picture. Is that right, Blail? Johnny's a funny guy. Alright, I'm just gonna jump to the bathroom. If you guys wanna send me some challenges, I think I might just like play some games against you guys. As you can see from my chest, it's the best time to beat me, so sign up, exclamation mark challenge. Trust me, you're never gonna get a better chance to beat me than right now. I'm just gonna go to the bathroom, I'll be right back. Fuck, I took a massive L on the Bucks. All right. Streaming the bathroom. What's up, boys? Girls. I say girls just in hope, you know, that tons of ladies are watching. Hello, ladies. Yeah. Fucking. Alright, we got some challenges here. Listen, I'm playing so fucking bad right now, it's crazy. You know who's outside? Isa. Fucking troll. Funny guy. Funny guy, Isa. Tom. Hello, Tommy. Tommy, you're much better online than in person, eh? Tommy Fook and Shelby quickly removed himself very early, so is not going to be around when I'm done streaming. He removed himself from the IRL location where I'm at, and he produced himself back in the online chat. There we go. Go, ladies. What's up? Samba, Bad Chess Good Vibes, JC Digital Girl. I'm, you know, you girls are the cornerstone of Chess Bro. Okay, I'll play Bishop Viewer. I want to get rid of that. Go Gory Hole. I also took the time to make sure to order another drink while I was up. Go Chicken Pants. Ralph, you and I have games that look a lot like this, eh? Ralph Wiggum, you fucking played this opening. Smith Mora for the boys. I guess I'll take it. I don't like the idea of taking it, but we'll do it. Chicken Pants, you know I got so fucked by this troll ending. Not only did they not kick a fucking field goal to help me cover the spread, but I also got messed up by your buddy Jalen Hurts, who's out there just going for 2-point conversions for no goddamn reason. No reason at all. Disgusting. Rebecca, that is that's an idea that I think I could get about 3 ladies to sign, and that's about it. But that might be enough convincing. Yeah, I've already floated the idea of having a lady of the month, girl of the month, except I don't know, it sounded too sexualized when I first came up with it. Girl of the month, like a Sports Illustrated cover or something. F6. Yeah, I mean, I wanted to go F6. Shit's attacked. Gotta go E6 here. Much as I don't want to. Okay. Don't really get that move, but. Go me. I am both of those right now, Chicken Pants. Trust me. The Chicken Pins, that deserved to happen to you. You were offering odds that were way too good for what you were discussing, and you got punished for it. So, you know, that the way the world works, you deserve to have that happen to you. I'll rub that in all day, Jake Baines, because I just took enough L's to tide me over for a while. Mattis, you vying for bottom bitch of the month? We're gonna do bear of the month, bottom. I think Mattis is trying to vie for twink of the month and bear of the month. No, but Rebecca, you understand, bitch of the month. I can't have girls winning bitch of the month. I might end up in court. Buddy. Wonder Woman of the Month. That sounds a lot better, first of all. No question about it. Mike Morton, let's get a game, buddy. Great, good luck. Good luck. Great game to Easter. But the thing is, like, most of the girls that I interact with are sort of of the opinion that, I don't know if I can call it a cliche, but let's just say, like, like, over-representing women as empowered is kind of, like, taboo. I don't know, Wonder Woman of the Month. You girls don't need reassurance that you're awesome. You don't need this, like, Wonder Woman persona. Alipin. Yeah. Alipin is, it is what it is. Well, I got one. I got one girl saying, yeah, how about Wonder Woman of the Month? And I got another one saying, yeah, how about Bitch of the Month? I'm in a fucking predicament here. What the fuck am I supposed to do with that? Hey, what's up, Chess Hathaway? A Wonder Bitch of the Month? Also, on another note, I hate how the word slut has just got a bad reputation. It's, you know, it's a negative word. You don't want to call someone that. But I think it's a great word for what it describes, and I think it's a little bit sad that it's kind of gotten a very negative connotation to it. You know, there's not many words in the English language that so specifically describe something like that word does. I'm always a fan of very specific words being popular, but it's not a good word. Was it ever not negative? I don't think so. I think it was probably always negative. Yeah, I do the same thing, Tom and I. I've never in my life referred to a girl using that word. I don't think I ever would. It's just mean. But I call the boys sluts all the time. Let's bring the bishop out to f4. Thank you. Is that true, Tommy? Is that true, buddy? Marry her and you can call her anything. I leave that interpretation to you entirely, Tommy. It's interesting. Normally you don't want to like just offer that bishop for no reason, but I kind of get it. I think I have to take it. Mike's a strong player, man. He's got me under pressure here. I want to go there. Bishop on e3, I guess we will. Not married to the idea. I'm on sleeping. No, I'm looking at my phone. Definitely not sleeping. What's up, Chuby? When is St. Louis on the schedule? Eric's in St. Louis. Like, I mean, he will be tomorrow. I'm not in St. Louis. I've had a good, great time in New York City, though. I have to say. Chuby, tier 3. My God. 8 months, thanks, Chuby. Didn't send, dude. No, I did not see other GMs here. Was not the purpose of my trip, let's put it that way. No. You don't want to be having a GM get together. Trust me on that one. If there was a GM get together, I might relinquish my title. GM meetup is a very deep troll comment. Yeah, I mean, it's just all good moves. Not exactly sure what to do with this. Don't have a good feeling about this position. Well, chess dude guy, I mean, yeah. Jaren works for Hikaru full time. Do we hear from Jaren anymore? No. The last time I heard from Jaren was about trying to smooth over the copyright strike dilemma. So no, definitely do not hear from Jaren. This move stops queen h1 check, right? Which is nice. Nice to control some squares. I'm getting some free attacks on the queen and no checks, so that's good. I should take that immediately. Fuck that piece. Fuck that piece. Would I go clubbing with Hikaru? I mean, you guys might be surprised by the answer, but the answer is yes. Of course I go clubbing with Hikaru. Generally, when you go out, you're supposed to go out with unattractive people to make yourself look better. Let's go d5. Yeah, okay. I like the way he's playing. High energy, high energy. Yeah. Oh, God. Ugh. It's a full rook. He probably didn't fucking think of to hang the rook. Problem is, Mike Morton, if you looked at me today, you'd be like, yep, that's a guy hanging a full rook today. I can already tell you that. Mike. I'm sure in a different series of moves you could have flagged me as well. Very close game. I like this act. I don't think it was sound, but I like it. I like it. Not sure that it was sound. I'm not sure you played it perfectly after that, but I'm also not sure that I did either, so I thought it was a great try. GG, man. Yeah, that is true. That is true. Hikaru likes to say random things like, like, oh, Eric is bad for the channel, but, you know, Amon, he's a great guy. And he just brings a lot to chess. I love what Amon is doing. But I just don't know why he's teamed up with Eric. That's a big Hikaruism. He's said that multiple times. But it's, yeah, it's just some like weird thing to try to play in between the lines. Doesn't work very well. Yeah. That's a great point, John. Yeah, Eric, total slut. What am I doing with him? Hello, Mattis. Is there a way to support the chess bros without supporting Eric? There is. Mattis, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. So if everyone else who's watching the stream could just mute for a second, then that'd be good. I'd just like to have a conversation with Mattis. I will let you in on a little secret, buddy. Everyone else mute. So Mattis, I will be releasing another Instagram picture within the next couple days. And I have not released an Instagram picture in a year, more than a year. This is big news for me. I think I got a picture in New York City that might be marketable. And trust me, I'm a hard guy to market, but I think it might be worth posting. So, Mattis, just wanna let you know that will be occurring, and I wanted you to be the first one to be able to like it. Okay, everyone can unmute. Everyone can unmute. All unmute. Focus, unmute. Microphone, good. Microphone, good. Unmute. Thanks, Mattis. Thank you, Mattis. Yeah. Tell everyone to unmute. I want to make sure everyone comes back here with us. Any unmuters? There we go. All right, Tom. Go, Tom. Jazz Nick only to the 8 months. Do you have any cute pics in New York City? No, not really. If I did, I certainly wouldn't post them anywhere. No way, what is this? Did the party slow down already? The party's, I would say the party's done. There was a DJ here. This place closes pretty much around now, so I'm about to be like kicked out in a good way. Like, I know that you can usually only stream till around now, but the event's done for sure. John Cadison, I see your chats. I just realized you were sending a challenge as well. Let's take that. This is a huge move. Check. Attacking the rook. When you take the rook, you get another queen. And if he takes back, his bishop's hanging on g4, so he's in a fucking rough position, bud. This. It's a decent move. Check. Unfortunately, he's gonna end up down a rook, I think. So let's take it, let's take here, and then we will be up a rook. And that's decent, I mean, not too bad. I mean, Grilled Peppers is playing on, and he's just like asking to get in trouble. Grilled Pep. He really shouldn't still be here. Yeah, absolutely stay frosty. Thanks to Reset, by the way. 4 months, man. We will be back to usual in 2 days.
Sorry, I missed that. Could you say it again?
I just wanted to cheers with you for the L's that even I was trying to be sharp. I did 6.5. I lost at 6.5. So like,
yeah,
right?
That's worse.
Like, so I even try to get ahead of it. I'm just saying, I'm in the same boat as you.
You're in a boat that capsized first.
I did. Yeah. We took some losses because I would have won at 7. So, The Bucks spread took an L. Aranji, I got an offer for you. Orlando, EDC, why don't you bring yourself over EDC next month. I know you like Florida. I know you like the Latina ladies and you like music. EDC. So EDC Orlando in November is the easiest place for us. You got some ladies that want to go to Tulum.
Oh, okay.
Oh. He's been asking about Tulum.
I'm, I got your Instagram. I'm going to message.
Hello.
We're going to beat ESAP. $100 a game.
This is not.
$100 a game.
Who do you think? What?
Alternating chess is 1-1 now. Cause
do you guys actually
have you mean this team?
Yes.
Against that team?
Yeah, but he's starting to hang
pieces. I go DMO, and then also need to go no Venmo.
Yeah. Well, Aranji, you didn't mention that ladies were coming.
Cash because Aman sometimes can't carry cash. It's
no.
Liability.
Aman can't carry cash.
He's very recognizable.
Aranji didn't mention their ladies coming when he asked about lodging.
No, he didn't. But he's bringing it up now.
Okay, but then I have to put Tama in the pool and put the ladies in the bedrooms? Sure. Now.
That's fine.
No, I got a suite.
Yeah?
We're good.
We're talking about Tulum.
Bring them all over.
Tulum. Oh, Tulum. Oh, you have a suite here?
No, you have a suite in Tulum, you're saying. So you're going to be in Tulum.
I can't go to Tulum.
I know. It's birthday. I know, I'm fucking with you.
If it wasn't, I would be able to.
I believe you. You're a man of action.
All right, I'm ready. Oh, I like it. We're going to hydrate and beat these guys.
Yeah. Do they have a limit on me?
Oh, on the time? I haven't heard it. The guy's... We got. I know. I haven't heard anything. No.
Well... After this guy and him,
we'll buy the suits,
after this guy and him, they got a great relationship now.
Yeah, I think I just spent more money here than ever has been spending in life. The first bartender was like,
Gopher and Tom, you guys are sharing a couch bed,
but
and we're bringing some
today,
ladies to Tulum.
Nothing. I didn't see anything being spent.
I'm sitting at the bar and I'm like, the DJ sucked, but his wife was great, and the bartenders.
Yeah, was that who that was?
No, yes. But we were talking about something else, and then some people here are like, you guys talking about NFTs?
No.
And the
conversation,
it was like some crack. Even though I own NFTs, they were discussing it like it was like crack.
y'all got any of that?
No, it was like that. It was like that. I was like... Cheers to you and Big Bogue. Big Bogue is helping rally.
Bogue is here.
He's helping rally oil and gas stocks recently, and they're going up. So Big Bogue.
But Big Bogue is rallying the wrong stocks. I don't have fucking oil.
So what do you want Big Bogue to help you rally?
Fucking.
Shopify can get Big. Just.
Shopify would be great.
Okay.
Shopify would be great. I'd like to invest in us, you know?
Did you hear that,
We're
bogus?
Shopify guys, you know?
Can we get some shit? Jeez.
Chessmaster Mark, thank you for the raid. Stay frosty. Gifted Mel, Tom GG, bro. Yeah. Now we get some good people here. Go people. Oh, Liquor Mark. Okay. Wait a minute. You changed your fucking name, dude. What? Liquor Mark wasn't selling on the liquor markets or what? I actually always did like the name Liquor Mark. Chessmaster Mark? Not a fan. I'll be honest with you. I like the name Liquor Mark. It's a cool name. This guy's fucking beating me tonight. He's taking my livelihood. I didn't even fucking see this, man. Like, I'm out of it, man. I'm out of it. I don't know why. I got a fucking weird feeling I'm gonna win this game. Weird feeling I'm gonna win this game. He knows that he should be attacking here, though, because I can't castle this way. I actually cannot castle, so I'm gonna avoid it. I'm gonna put my king here manually, and I'm gonna survive. See you, Tom. See you soon. Very soon. Yeah, so, I mean, I want to go there, but d5. Just run the king. D4 is a move. Go here, try to stop it. C5, D4 is coming though, and it's coming quickly. I want to play G3, King, G2, but it's not going to be that quick. How do you ask your manager at work out on a date? Your manager is hot. Chess dude guy. How do you ask your manager out on date? I'm not the expert there, man. Does anyone have any advice for this man? Asking your manager out on a date? Like, first of all, shouldn't you even be evaluating if that's even a smart idea? Okay, here's a question. Has anyone in the chat right now ever had any type of relationship, even one that lasted less than 24 hours, with anyone they work with? Coworker, manager, person of seniority, mailman, fucking anything. Out of curiosity. And for the people saying yes, can you elaborate? Was it a serious person? Not a serious person in your life. I mean, like, serious person in the company. I'm looking for the one that, like, you know, went for the manager type of thing. Jeffrey. You got lucky juices loose? What does that mean? We make a draw, except I don't make a draw. I flag you. Very nice. I'm gonna flag you for sure. Very nice. That was a pawn there. How did I win a pawn from a hanging pawn? That should happen never amount of times. Ever. I might win now. Now I'm gonna win. Oh! Go me. The only way I can fucking win today. Go me. One more win, and I actually end the stream at 2700, which is a fucking miracle for how bad I've played. Oh, hang on a sec. I gotta revisit this chat. Guys, we just talked about asking bosses on dates, and I asked who's done that before, or who's at least like done that with someone who they work with, whether it's a boss or coworker. It's actually so many people said yes. So many people. You guys are fucking animals. Every single one of you. Yeah, it's a lot of fucking animals in chat. Now, some of you might work in an industry where it is like pretty much normal. Maybe half of you are strippers. And if you're telling me that you bang someone where you work, I might be like, okay, yeah, that doesn't fucking matter. But if you tell me you're in investment banking, that matters. Hootie style. Listen, you could be telling the truth, or you could not, but either way, speaking on strippers, banging industry, not only is that super common, but I feel like it has the worst effect in a weird way. You might think, oh, investment banker, banging your boss, that's like the worst thing that could happen to you, but I've heard the horror stories about strippers banging who they work with, and that is bad. That can fuck you up. It does happen everywhere, Boris. It does, definitely. What's up, Sosatan? You can't go back to work because you broke up with the girlfriend you work with? And your name is Masturbator24. I mean, I don't know how serious you expect me to take you, Masturbator24. That's a big chief right there. Your ex left you for her coworker? Well, when you think about it, Fred's beard, if she left you for her coworker, technically you and that guy were also coworkers. You guys were working the same fucking piece of ass for a while. So she actually left you for your coworker. Brought 200 IQ. Go Eskimo Bros. Alright, John, good luck, bro. Mon needs to attend sensitivity training. I don't know. It's probably a downside. It's probably a big negative of mine. Maybe that's why ladies don't like me. But I am, I don't know. I can be very blunt. I can appear insensitive. I'm very much a realist, and I often just say things that are true, even if they're mildly inappropriate. Like what you just heard. Just how I am. I can be fairly emotionless. I mean, a6 next looks good. I'm gonna get the bishop pair. Right about that. So. I'll take that and I'll win this. That's a pawn. Yeah, I don't, it can be a good or bad thing. Depends who you're dealing with, right? Chicken pants, but you know, that is very much me. That is very much me. Yeah, Zebra 420 Pepe. Zebra 420 Pepe. John is not playing a bad game right now, but missing the long diagonal has cost him a pawn. A4, I don't know about that. I'm actually playing playlists from Eric's Spotify, so it's not like a chessbrah playlist right now. Dr. Lord Mayonnaise. Do you chicken pants? I don't know. As I said, these are like noise canceling, so I don't actually know what you guys hear. You guys probably hear more than me about like what's going on around me. These are pretty serious headphones. Howdy, Super Saiyan. Thank you, Dr. Lord Mayonnaise. 7 gifted subs. I should probably be playing d4, taking on b3. The people with the doing dishes sounds are, you know, I would say it's certainly not him. Pawn takes b5, I guess. That'll take your.
We're looking at a 16 minute time frame. About half 12.
Sounds good. And that's a lot, Dr. Lord. I mean, when you think about how it's accrued over the years, that is something special. Chicken Pants, thanks for the 10 subs. 10 gifted subs from Big Chick. Thank you to CD Lamb and Chicken Pants. Save the bishop, I guess. Take this. Whoa, what the fuck? Dr. Lord Mayonnaise. Hang on one fucking sec. So, Bishop here, there's queen b5, and I don't fucking want to deal with that. So better to go queen here. That way, if queen b5, I take with check. And if he trades queens, then I just queen my a pawn very easily. So that's why I did that. Bishop c4. Yeah, that is now 1k gifted for Dr. Lord Mayonnaise. He came in with 20 gifted subs. Pretty sure he was saying that he was that close to the very, very official 1,000 gifted subs. And that should be on the dot. Thank you very much, Dr. Lord Mayonnaise. Dude, 1,000 is pretty serious. Pretty fucking serious. Wasn't the fastest, mate. Listen, I trust you. I trust you. If you say it's not the fastest, you're the boss. John Curtis, is that you? No way, that's you. GG, either way. Go-goers. Big go energy right now, Dr. Lord. Hours is a long time, Bogus, especially at this hour of night, right? Oh, there's John Kittison. It was another John. That's what I thought. GG. Pleasure, man. Pleasure is mine. We are late night wrapping up. Yeah, I have no extra points. I'm gonna play one game, I think, because if I win, I get to be 2,700, yay! And if I lose, which I probably will, then I'll just be further in the 2,600 hole, and I'll make that up as soon as I get back. I'll be flying back tomorrow, so hope to be back streaming seriously as soon as possible. Blind Time Alex, thanks for 100 bits. Basmaniac, 500 bits. Let's play one more game in the pool. GG's to everyone that played. I do also have to end pretty soon. Just, this place doesn't stay open forever. But it's been good. It's been good. I'll tell you guys all about my trip when I get back. Let's get one more game. Only one more. The thing is, I can't like lose and then make up over time or just play a bunch of games to make up for it. No, I have to win this game. Last attempt. Probably losing. It's very losing. That's exactly why. How do we try? Because I think we're just fucked. Bishop b3 should just win next. There should be no way. No way. Yeah. It's too much. There should be three. There should be three. I see a lot of ways that this does not end well, but. Rook c1's a good move. I was gonna play b5. He takes and takes. He takes and takes. Not much that can happen. I guess I'll play another couple moves, but these moves don't really matter. Be ending off regardless after. I have bishop e7 as a last move, but obviously my queen is not going to be permitted to stay there, so. A3 just wins, and I don't have anything to play. I'm not gonna waste this time. I trust them. GG's. I'm out. As I said, it's, I can barely think. Not a good chess player right now. I am out. Thanks for watching. You guys have been good. I will be back in a couple days. I'll be streaming back from Calgary. I miss it. Be straight back to it. Take care. I don't even think I can raid you guys anywhere, but hopefully you find somewhere good to go. I gotta dip out. Take care, guys. Bye for now. And like I said, I'll see you guys soon. Yeah, he played well, Bogus. What can I say? He played well. I'm in no shape to compete with real chess players right now. Bye, guys. Miss ya, love ya, and see you soon.